Sometimes when I have a problem that I'm trying to solve, if I let go of it, it presents itself in a dream at times. And sometimes there's a wall at the studio right now. It's made of Coca-Cola and bronze. And I had a reoccurring dream in Austria, in Vienna, when I was there. And I was there to attend a World Craft Congress, and I was a representative from the United States. This was years and years ago. And I had started having that dream on a Monday, and it continued until I left the conference every day. And in the dream, I just saw the center portion of the wall piece that's hanging in my studio today. And the outside had cloud formations, just like that, around the edge. And with every night, it would open until I saw the whole completed piece. So I made a drawing of it, and I was invited to a show at the Craft and Folk Art Museum called Made in L.A., and I had that piece fabricated. And it meant using all the money I had to see it fabricated the way it should, it made the way it should be made, because I had not worked in brass at that time or anything like that, any metals. So I designed it and I had it fabricated. And you know, it was sold the first night to the American Embassy in Hungary. There was a coup in Hungary, it was gone. The sale was gone the next day. It went into crates for 20 years. I moved to this studio and I decided to hang it up. So there it is. And that was dream.
It's
still for sale. Yes. It hasn't found its home.
So, tell us about some of the more important monumental works that you've done.
Well, I think Villa Park, the homage to Quetzalcoatl and at Villa Park that was commissioned by the city of Pasadena is fabulous. It's a monolith. It's 24 feet wide by 35 feet high. And I made all the forms. It took a year to make the forms and have and cast them for the face of the wall. And the theme of it is the dragon. I mean, and Quetzalcoatl, and he had a twin brother who was evil. So I had him on that piece as well, because there's a duality to everything, you know, the good and the bad. And on that piece, I used different forms that reflected the mathematical genius of the Maya and also the Aztec. I even devised a system of how to hang it based on, you know, what the engineer had said, because these are heavy, heavy units of cement, and it's faced with brass, and I epoxied the brass and cut the brass, and I had someone else help me with all of that. And when the engineer came to the studio, we were getting ready for a casting, and he turned to Epi and said, my friend Epi, who was the cement guy, and said, "Splendid job. You were so intelligent in how you devised the system for hanging the units for to accept the..." There were units that were stainless steel that had to be suspended in the form that was being cast. So I devised a system to do that, to suspend it in a particular way. But he gave Epi the credit. And I to this day, I'm resentful about it, because I was the one that thought of it and I didn't speak up. You know, I think you really have to speak up, because... Oh, I'm sorry. There, you know, it's important. Moss Kojima came to the studio one day, and Moss Kojima was working for Tom Bradley at that time. He was his right-hand man, and he was a dear, dear friend of mine. I just adored him. And he was on KPFK and had a radio station and was very liberal and really highly intelligent, and I adored him. He's passed away since, but he said, "Dora, that wall." And I said, "Yes, what about it?" It was stacked in the backyard. And he said, "Oh, what would you think about it going to Nagoya, Japan, as the formal, you know, gift from the city of Los Angeles?" And I said, "Great, but I'm not going to pack it." He laughed. And then he said, "Okay, well, I'm going to bring someone over for you to meet." And so with the next meeting, he brought Tosh Tarasawa. He's an architect who's been very active in the Nagoya Sister City program. And Tosh loved the wall. And so he arranged for Toyota to crate it, pack it, and ship it to Nagoya.
And it's still there, correct?
It's still there. It was installed on my birthday on a placard, and it was the official gift to the city of Nagoya in 1979.
And did you go to the opening?
I was sent as the guest of the government for a month. I stayed in Japan for a month. It was unbelievable. The montage was a fabulous experience because 2 years before, I had written in my book, God, I'm ready for a big job. I mean a big job with lots and lots of money. I said that in the book. 2 years later, this job comes through. It was unbelievable. I did the presentation to the client at the site with three different possibilities. He selected one. He wanted, and it all took place within 6 minutes. He said, that, I want you to do it. Just like that, you to do it, you know, like this. It was like a dream come true. I could not believe it. I hired seven people. I hired my daughter to run the job. Because she has an eagle eye. She can walk into a room and find a 16th of inch difference in something. We had pressed all this tile before she got involved in the project. She came to the studio. She said, it's an eighth of an inch off. I said, an eighth of an inch off? You're crazy. You know, we were ram pressing. I bought a little ram press and we were popping along. I thought, boy, we're going to get done with this really quickly. We had pressed, I don't know, hundreds of tiles. We couldn't use them. Had to have the mold remade. I had checked everything, but you know, there was so much to see to. Anyhow, we got it done on time. It was installed and it's beautiful. I wanted to do an homage to the goddess because she's the fountain of creativity. The tree of life has been in every religion just about that I've read about. And I know that temples have been obliterated over and over again that had to do with the fertility of the goddess and that kind of thing. So this is in part to pay homage to the goddess, the Mother Earth, who is all giving. And the front panel of the sculpture is a tree of life with all the little animals. I had some of the animals looking down so that smaller children, they could connect to the sculpture by, you know, looking up, and then the animal is looking down at them. And not all of them are goddesses. I mean, there's one that's the ocean. It's an homage to the ocean with a lot of fish and turtle and all sorts of creatures. But at the base, there are tiles representing the Cambrian period where creatures first got eyeballs. And so those black tiles represent the foundation of where life came from. I mean, to this day, there are sponges in various parts of the world, and especially at the Barrier Reef, that if you press them, they give off oxygen. And they actually oxygenated the whole planet, these sponges. I mean, it's amazing. And I made a goddess to water, you know, because it's fluid and it's fabulous and it's beautiful. And I used cullet, which melts at a high temperature. And then the last one is very abstract. It's wind, and it's all celadon, and it's very, very ethereal, I think. It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
And what does having a retrospective mean to you?
It means a reflection of for me personally, it's been very emotional because I can't believe I'm the age I am. I'm the oldest I am today that I've ever been. I'm 75 years old now. And it's, you know, to look back and to see pieces coming to the studio that I did in 1956, 57, is the remembrance of my whole life and how everything has evolved and how lucky I've been, really. And to even have this exhibition is unbelievable because I never really seeked it out, you know? I never looked for it. It was presented by other people to the museum, and the museum approved it, and I've been working on it for 16 months now. I've worked on those sculptures. And it was, I took it upon myself to make the sculptures. The museum didn't ask me to do it because I wanted to present the most recent expression of my work in the year of my life on Earth, you know, my 75th year. This is what I created during my 75th year on Earth. I'm very grateful for all, everyone, you know, my friends and my family especially, and my friends, of course, my daughter, my grandchildren, everybody. It's, you know, it's wonderful.